हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू रॉकेट साइंस एंड इंजीनियरिंग। टुडे आई विल कंटिन्यू विद द क्वेश्चंस रिलेटेड टू द फर्स्ट चैप्टर दैट वी हैव डन, व्हिच वाज द इंट्रोडक्शन टू द रॉकेट साइंस। एंड वी हैव डिस्कस द डेवलपमेंट ऑफ रॉकेटरी, एंड वी हैव कवर्ड मेनी टाइम पीरियड्स ड्यूरिंग विच द रॉकेट्स वर डेवलप्ड एंड द एडवांसमेंट मेड इन द फील्ड ऑफ रॉकेटरी। एंड टुडे वी विल sort of review the chapter and by discussing the questions. Okay, so first is, what is the relevance of early pile and why it is first demonstration of rocketry? So as I have already explained you in my previous videos, that it is something like this. Okay, so below it is a frame. We provide steam to this. And inside it there is a water. So when water get heated up, it becomes steam, and steam escapes out of these nozzles. Okay, so it then rotate this spherical tank. Okay, by making use of Newton laws of motion. We know that when equal and opposite forces, okay, act perpendicular like this. Okay, when equal and opposite forces act parallel to each other in opposite direction, then they produce torque. Torque is the rotational motion. So this spherical tank start rotating. Okay, so some people thought it as the first steam engine. Okay, a sort of first steam engine, and it was the first time that people have made use of Newton's law. Okay, because as we see in rocketry, that the escape gases push the rocket upward. In the similar way, the steam coming out from these nozzles help to turn this spherical tank, rotate the spherical tank. So, okay, so it is a demonstration of the Newton's law in application. Okay, now the next question is, what are the components of gunpowder? Gunpowder is sulfur, charcoal, and potassium nitrate. Okay, so these are the main components of the gunpowder. Now the third question is, what is Principia and what contribution does it make to rocketry? Principia are the Newton's laws of motion, first, second and third, and the whole of the, you can say that rocketry is based on these principles or laws of Newton related to motion. First is the law of inertia. We state then an object at rest will remain at rest, or in uniform motion will remain in uniform motion until and unless an unbalanced force act on it. So if you see, when the rocket is on the launch pad, it remain at rest because no unbalanced force act on it. But when the gases escape out of it, then unbalanced force act on it, because the gases which are coming out of this bottom has more mass as compared to the rocket, so unbalanced force act on it, so it rises upwards. Okay, so this is first law. It explains first law. And third law, every action has equal and opposite reaction. So every action has equal and opposite reaction. So the rocket move in the opposite direction to the direction of escape of gases. Okay, and the second law states that the force is directly proportional, or acceleration is directly proportional to force. Okay, the more force you apply, the more acceleration will take place. So the more fastly the gases will come out of the nozzle, the more thrust it will provide to the rocket, and more acceleration it will build, and it will be able to escape the gravitational pull of the earth. So The Newton's laws are very much applicable to rocket science and engineering. Okay. Again, when rocket goes into space, okay, and when it is not under the gravitational pull of any celestial body, then it continues to move with uniform velocity in a straight path until and unless it comes under the gravitational pull of any celestial body, you can say Moon, Mars, okay, then it divert from its straight path, follow a curve, and start orbiting that body. Okay, so these are all the applications of Newton's law of motion to rocket science. So Principia plays a very important role in developing rocket science. Okay, so these are third question, three questions I want to discuss with you. So yearly pile is known also known as Hero's device. Okay.